Spanwise Adaptive Wing is about moving wing sections in flight to improve aircraft efficiency, whether it's a drag reduction or control authority or better stability. We are not the first ones that's doing this. In fact, this dates back to the early 60s, like the example of the XB-70. But what's different here and what's new is how do we fold those wings? At the heart of Spanwise Adaptive Wing project, we have this new multifunctional materials known as shape memory alloys, which change shape or remember different shapes as you heat them and cool them and can be used as actuators. Recently, back in a few months back, we did a flight test on a subscale aircraft using this new actuators, and in fact, for the first time, we use a new high temperature shape memory alloys developed at NASA Glenn based on nickel, titanium, hafnium, and this new materials have the right characteristics for flights, like transition temperatures and strength required for structure and actuation, and also the stability of the material itself. So now that we've done this flight test, we wanted to transition to a full-scale test, being this F-18 wing sections that we're demonstrating on. And with that, we took the existing hardware of the folding mechanism, which is a motor, electric motor, and a transmission, geared transmission, and we replaced that with a 5,000 and then a 20,000 inch-pound torque-rated actuators based on these shape memory alloys.
The most exciting technology development that's come out of the project, the Spanwise Adaptive Wing project, to me, is the alloy development and the shape memory alloy processing and fabrication of the shape memory alloy actuators that Boeing and NASA have been working on. We went from a single tube in the Terra at about 500 inch pounds to 12 tubes combined into a single assembly at 5,000 inch pounds. We built models, we simulated the 5,000 inch pound actuator with combined loads. We wrapped a controller around it so we were able to do closed loop control. And we did all of this before we ever ran it. We finally assembled it here in St. Louis, put it on the bench, and ran it. Our predictions matched almost exactly the performance, and the controller performed perfectly without any extra tuning.
I want to say that the F-18 is a good test bed and a source of requirements because it's a realistic product that's out there in service, and we're fortunate that NASA was able to provide this test bed to allow us to really test our technology against realistic work requirements. It's one thing to prove something in the lab, but it's a whole nother challenge to integrate into a realistic platform. And I feel that that's what we've done. This project is a major success.
The first test condition is from 0 to 90 degrees, or from horizontal to vertical, similar to the way an F-18 aircraft folds wings. In this case, the highest torque is at zero and then reduces as the wing section moves up. I should point out that it is controlled all the way, and we can dial any angle in this range from 0 to 90 with a very good precision. This next test condition is from minus 45 to 45 degrees. Since our project is not just about folding on the ground, but also in the flights, we need to evaluate how folding the wing down looks like. Here, the torque increases as we approach zero reference angle, the horizontal plane, and then decreases again as we reach the positive 45. And in a real flight scenario, this is the kind of loading or kind of torque that you would expect.
This ground demonstration is one of a kind on multiple fronts. We'll have a new and improved shape memory alloys, high torque actuators, and new mechanisms. Our next goal is to take it to the next level. learn what we've taken in ground testing and mature it into a full-scale flight-ready actuation system.
Terra was a 200-pound vehicle, which enabled us to validate our models and our simulation. While we flew Terra, we developed the current generation of SMA actuators. These actuators are going to allow us to take a supersonic vehicle that weighs 2,000 pounds to flight research, where we can fold the wings down in flight. While we're doing that effort, we're going to develop the next generation of actuators, which will enable us to take this to full-scale supersonic flight.